In January 2015, Dina Wakely and Ranger released four new colors of Media Paint and the Fine Line Applicator Tip, and we'll explore both in today's Midweek Muse video. I know everyone is super excited about the Fine Tip Applicator, so let's start there. For $9.99, you get a pack that looks like this that includes two separate tips. Now, this is actually comprised of three parts. You can unscrew. This is the cap, and you see this little pointy thing here? Let me turn it this way. That's the business end of this. That's what's going to go inside of that metal tip, and it's what's going to prevent clogging. Now, you want to make certain that you line that up every time you put the cap back on. This piece also will separate. Let's get these out of the way. So this base piece actually separates into two pieces like this, which I think would be very handy if it comes time to go ahead and need to clean this up. Maybe when you switch tubes, you go ahead and clean this all up so you're starting fresh. Sometimes when you take the cap off, let's get that back in there. Sometimes when you take the cap off, you might have screwed this on reasonably tightly and this comes apart. So what you get is the base coming apart like this. No big deal. Just put it back, and obviously now I need to line that back up. You just go ahead and put these pieces back together. And then as far as putting them on the tubes of paint, they have been, the inside threads here have been made to match the threads on the paint. So it's a simple matter of going ahead and screwing it on, and now what you have is a writing device, or a dotting device, or a doodling device, and that's the most amazing part about this. Now, just because you have this on here doesn't mean you can't squeeze some out on your work surface and use it with a brush. I'm not going to bother to put these back on. It's kind of a waste of time. I just prefer to leave the applicator tips on here and then just obviously go ahead and do this. Now, having said that, so I have something I want to doodle on. What I want to do first is shake the tube so I know that the product has fallen forward and into the tip. And then I'm going to start, well, you won't see it if I do it here. I'm going to start off to the side. I just want to make certain that the paint is flowing, and it is. So now what I can do is come in and I can outline the shapes here as they were put on this page by the stencil. Now, I'm not doing a particularly good job, but you get the sense of what's going on. It's very easy to go ahead and do some lining like this. If you, let's get this out of the way. Let's bring in a piece of deli paper. If you move the tip faster than you're squeezing, and that'll make sense when you actually do it, you can get a graduated line. So for example, see what I got there was a very thin line. Now if I squeeze harder as I move that, I'm going to get a thick bead of paint, but you can kind of play with this so that you get all different kinds of things going on here. So that's the essence of what goes on with the tip, but there are some other ways that you can use this as well. Now, I find it's easier if I put my finger on there, even though I have reading glasses on so I can see what I'm doing. I find it easier when I'm going to put this little needle back into the tip. I find it easier to actually line it up with my finger and do it that way. So I'm going to go for absolute luxury, and I'm going to have one of these on all of my tubes. It just makes everything so much easier. I've got them converted into writers, and I'm ready to go at any time. Because I like curvy organic shapes, dots are a design element that I use quite frequently. And you can see that I've got part of this house done. This is one of our wonky wood houses. What you can't feel, and if your fingers were here they could, is that these dots are dimensional. They actually are raised off the surface. Because Dina's paint is a heavy body acrylic, it's going to maintain the dimension that you put it out in, whether it's a line or, in this case, a dot. So all I'm going to do is take this off. Give this a shake. Now I'm going to grab a piece of paper towel just to wipe the tip off a little bit, and I want to make certain, well, where you can see it, I want to make certain that the paint is flowing, which it is. So now all I'm going to do is come in here and I can start putting the dots on. So it's just a question of putting the tip where you want it, squeezing until you get the amount of paint on there that creates the size dot that you want, and then lifting. You can place these close together, or you can spread them a little bit farther apart. I'm trying to just sort of maintain what I did already so it more or less matches. Now, you don't need to see me do this whole thing, but the one thing that you'll notice, let's just put this back on. The one thing that you'll notice is, and I'm going to hold this so that you can hopefully see it. See the characteristic kind of Hershey Kiss shape that you get from lifting that tip off? It's very easy to fix that. Now, if you had a piece of paper, and I'll show you this, you just would put your finger underneath and flick, but you can't exactly flick this. So it's just a question of tapping this a couple of times, and then you see that these pieces that, or excuse me, these mounds, the Hershey Kiss shape starts to go, and it becomes more of a rounded mound rather than a pointy Hershey Kiss. So when you're working, let's get this out of the way. When you're working on something like, this is an art card. Now, I've already got dots on here that I did with a Sharpie paint pen, but I could bring the black in, and now I can put dimensional dots on here, which would be really cool because it gives it a far more tactile feel. Again, I'm just going to give this a shake and make certain I've got paint coming out. And now what I have is an art card with really cool dimensional embellishments on it. And I could do that all the way around. Again, just put the lid on that. Again, what I would do is to come up underneath, flick that a couple of times, and now what you see on that angle, you can see that they're mounded and rounded rather than pointy and kissy. All right, so let's talk about deli paper, because I find myself working on it a lot lately, and I really like the graphic effect of white and black on whatever the background is. So once again, let's just kind of clean this off, and I can come and do this. Now, I admittedly, there is a bit of a learning curve to learning how to handle the tube and the tip, but you can see that it's, you know, not a huge learning curve. And again, as I said earlier, depending on how much pressure you put when you squeeze, you can either get sketchy or you can get a solid line like this. So it works really well. Now, something else that you can do, and I'm going to demo this on deli paper, but it could certainly be done on any kind of paper. It just happens to be what I have handy. But I do want to show you this because it's kind of cool. Let's get that out of the way. Whoops. So if I bring in a piece of deli paper, and I'm just going to use white for this. Now, I can draw a squiggly line. Squeeze the tube, I could draw a squiggly line that looks like that, and that's pretty cool. But if I instead come in, and rather than leave this like this, if I come in with my handy dandy plastic scraper and I pull, you can see that I get a far different effect. So I get this really cool pattern here. Now if I had, in fact I can do that, if I had come in and I do this and I turn this way, let's just wipe the excess paint off of my scraper here, and I do this. Again, get the excess paint off the scraper so it doesn't do that. I get this really cool look, and now I can build this element that has these scalloped edges on either side. So there's lots of different ways that you can work with this fine tip applicator. Coming back to the metallic paint, I want to show you a couple of things that you can do with it that you might not necessarily have thought of. Now again, I'm not going to worry about using the tip as a tip here. I'm just going to use it to dispense some paint and onto my nonstick craft sheet. There we go. Sometimes even with the glasses, it doesn't help. All right, so now what I'm going to do is take a brush that has some water in it, and I'm just going to create a wash of this is Penny. So it's a kind of a, excuse me, if this is, yes, Penny. So it's kind of a copper color, which works really well with what I have going on here. So I'm going to thin it down because I don't want to obliterate what's here. I just want to add an all-over wash of the Penny color. So all I'm going to do is just come in. And what will happen is that obviously the more water you put in this, the more you thin the pigment and the mica or whatever it is that makes this metallic. So bear that in mind. But the thinner you make it, the lighter the wash will be. But you can see that you can create a whole different look by washing this over this page spread, and what it does is it gives me this nice copper colored glimmer on this entire sheet, or excuse me, page spread here with very, very little effort. And pretty much that's done now. Just grab a little bit more to finish this side. So super, super easy. Just put that to one side and let it dry and you're good to go. And now this whole spread has a lovely coppery glimmer on it. But that's not the only thing you can do. You all know that I'm very fond of spattering. So what I'll do is bring in a fan brush, and I'm going to thin this down. Now the consistency here is going to be a thicker than what I just did a moment ago, because I was trying to create a very thin, transparent wash, and that's not what I'm going for here. Now what I want to do is just create enough liquid in this fan brush so that when I tap, I can get speckles all over this. Now, this is a fairly small piece, but you certainly can see the effect here. So whether you use it straight from the tube and you use it with a brush in traditional painting methods, whether you put the fine tip applicator on and you draw or scribble with it, or whether you thin it out and make a wash, the new metallic colors in black are just wonderful, and of course that fine tip applicator is a wonderful device as well.